in investing in wine. It's a niche that has grown a lot over the last 2 decades.
Wine investments should be looked at different angles and positions. One, purely focused on return, on yield based on trading. And the other one, which is based on importing and selling, trading on a shorter term with a continuous demand. It's important to differentiate the two approaches.
There's a social dimension, there's the passion, and there's a financial dimension as well.
Wine is a very interesting product as an investment tool. So I thought, you know, I had to learn a little bit more so that I can have a more in-depth conversation with my clients.
I can use whatever I'm learning here to better help my clients making the right choice. I will have more tools to support my point of view.
I'm actually quite interested to know what I can do with my current collection, which I have around 600 to 700 bottles. So I was wondering, you know, whether this course could actually help me to identify more wines that were undervalued so that I can actually further grow my collection.
Actually, my research is not just on wine. I'm interested in several topics related to hospitality industry, restaurant economics, also in finance, alternative investment. And I think what is cool about wine is that you are kind of in the middle of all those topics. So there's financial dimension attached to fine wines, but there are also some gustatory dimensions attached to wine, services to the hospitality industry as well. So I think that this is what is very interesting. So it's kind of in between the different topics.
Have too many sources of data, and it's hard to know how to prioritize the input that we receive. The objective was to first go back to basics, remind people what builds a trend in the wine industry, what are the foundations on pricing, to look at the different forces in the market that are going to make prices move up or move down.